Cooks the Man here. Starting up a new series I'll be calling Bite-Sized Reviews, where I'll be talking about video games I've played and I'll be giving my honest opinion about them. Now bear in mind, my opinion is entirely subjective. And by subjective, I mean objective. As in, if your opinion deviates from mine, I'm gonna fucking find you. But that's besides the point. So today we're gonna talk about MechWarrior 5, and what a disappointing piece of shit that game really is. Now I came to this conclusion once I started playing the older MechWarrior games, where I realized they had a lot more features that MechWarrior 5 simply doesn't have, just because the developers decided, fuck it, I don't want it there. And that line of thinking is honestly pretty fucking retarded, because why the hell would I pay $30 for a game that has less features than the one that came before it, and even less features than the one that came out, like, what, a little over 20 years ago? But let me not get ahead of myself, and let's get down to basics and check out the details of what this game has to offer before I talk shit about it, starting off with gameplay. So how's the gameplay of MechWarrior 5? Honestly, it's really fucking good. It's pretty fun. Running around in big-ass robots has never felt better before. Controls are pretty smooth, shooting feels fine, and the variety of weapons you have available is, not too bad, especially considering the year this game is set in. That being said, though, the enemy AI and friendly AI is fucking horrible. You ever seen what a lobotomy does to people? Just play the game and you'll see exactly what I mean with the AI. Now, the AI in previous titles has exactly been good either, but like, come on, you're a technical studio, you should be able to develop an AI that actually knows where it's going, what it's shooting at, but apparently it's too hard for Piranha to make, so whatever. Moving away from the AI, how's the rest of the stuff, like the maps? How are the maps? Well, let's just say procedurally generated, boring and generic seems to be the running theme here. Almost like Piranha Games seems to have a bit of a lazy habit going on, maybe a bit too much. Even some of the fucking side quests, they have generated maps. Like, come on, couldn't make anything custom like the main missions? No. Oh, okay, that's fine, it's all right, it's fine. But Tux, what the fuck the maps have to do with the gameplay? Well, fucking everything, because here's the deal, it's procedurally generated maps feel fucking empty and copy pasted. Not a single one of the missions feels unique in any way, not even the side missions. So what ends up happening is that you just lose interest in everything that's going on. You don't pay attention to the story, you don't pay attention to anything. Everything feels the same. Doesn't matter what wall of text you shoot at me, it doesn't feel any different from the last mission I did. And that's another thing. The mission types. There's like five of them. Five? Why? You only get a few more if you get the DLC. And the only real time you get unique missions is when you're doing the main quests. Because the side content of the base game, all you're getting is the same missions over and over and over again. Unless, of course, you fork over more cash for the DLC. And that's the biggest thing that annoys me. If you want an actually finished game to play, you gotta give these lazy pricks even more money. So in other words, if you want a game that's more consistent to the older games, you gotta cough up more money on top of the money you already paid for the base game. Because I have the shit that came out for the DLC was shit that should have been there from the beginning. And don't even get me started on the fucking mech lab, Jesus Christ. Like, genuinely, what the fuck is wrong with these people? What's with the constant need to limit the player's options and customization of their own mechs in the past couple of Battletech games? So far, only MechWarrior Online has actually bothered to copy the tabletop mech lab as it should be. And even then, they limit you. Even the Battletech RTS, that I would argue has an even more faithful mech lab to the tabletop, still limits your customization options. Although in that case, it does make a little more sense considering you're in the periphery. But that's besides the point. Why the hell does MechWarrior 5 Mercenaries limit you so goddamn much? Because it's like this. You can't change your armor type, you can't change your searcher type, you can't change your engine type. You can't even strap weapons onto the hardpoint if they're too big for it. Like, genuinely, what the hell were they thinking? The MechWarrior games have always been known for your ability to customize to that level. So where's my Endo Steel? Where's my XL engine? Where's my ferrofibrous armor? I'll tell you where it went. Went down the gutter with the rest of the features that showed up in the last games. Because the pricks of Piranha are too fucking lazy to implement any of this into their own game. And then there's the so-called fans, who think this shit is fine, that it's okay to limit your customization, just because the story is supposed to take place in 3025, or because it's for balancing reasons or something. Get the fuck out of here. The game's timeline can stretch out over 3049. At that point, you should already have most of the technology available. In fact, you get new mechs. Also, it's a single-player game. What the fuck do you mean balancing? You should be able to do whatever the fuck you want. But no, poor Piranha. Can't put all that. It's too hard for them. Yeah, let's just pull up Bethesda and let the modders do everything for us. Fan-fucking-tastic. So yeah, MechWarrior 5 has solid base for gameplay, but is hampered by the shitty maps, shit AI, shit mission design, and the lack of core features that have been available since 1996. But yeah, enough of this shit. Let's move on to the story. The story's so boring it's not even worth mentioning, but here's the gist of it anyway. Poor old dad gets murked. You're angry, so you go after the people who killed him. And that's pretty much it. Also, you're a clanner. Yeah, that's about as subtle as they put it. Now, on to music. It's alright. Not great, not terrible. There's a few standout tracks, but overall it's kind of mediocre. Here's a few samples. Moving on. Visuals. Graphics are alright. Nothing to write home about. The mechs do look a bit too shiny though. Not a big fan of that. The designs are copy-paste from MechWarrior Online, so there's really nothing fancy about it. The one complaint I do have is about the weapon visuals. The missiles and the lasers specifically. For some reason, they decided to make missiles look like giant-ass fireballs, which I'm not a big fan of, and the laser beam effects just make them look like giant laser pointers, which makes zero sense, considering last I checked, these lasers are supposed to melt right through steel. So having lasers look like laser pointers doesn't exactly make them more intimidating, which is made even worse by the fact you can barely see them in snow biomes. So overall, they could have done a lot better job with the visuals. Moving on, let's talk DLC. Now, unfortunately, I haven't been able to get my hands on all the DLC considering they're expensive as hell. And I'm a broke motherfucker, but it is what it is. But I've managed to get my hands on at least 4 of the DLC, and, they're not bad. Well, most of them. Call to Arms is probably, like, the weakest one I've played, considering it's literally just a small side quest you get. Like, the biggest thing it has is just melee weapons in the game, and that's pretty much it. Then you have Heroes of the Inner Sphere, and that's honestly a pretty good one. Just like Call to Arms, just adds small little side quests you can do, but they're not that bad. Mostly what they just do is give some new hero mech designs to fuck around with, and some of the side stories are actually kinda good. My favorite one being the one with the Victor where you have to climb up the mountain, and you got two ways of getting up there, either by either making a direct assault on their base or going around it and trying to avoid the ECM jammers. Just a small fun DLC you can play with. Then you have Razor Hog and Kestrel Lancers. Out of the 4 I played, I'd say that those 2 are definitely my top favorite ones, especially Kestrel Lancers, because the campaign puts you through. It's really fun for me personally. And unlike the rest of the game, it actually feels like a Battletech story. Unfortunately, my biggest gripe with the DLC is the fact that all the features that they include should have been there in the base game from the beginning. But I'll touch on that later in the video. Next up, let's talk about bugs. This is the only thing I'll commend Piranha about doing, and that's fixing the bugs of this game. There were a lot of them on launch. And in the year of our Lord, 2024, I've only witnessed 2 bugs in my entire playthroughs. So yeah, not bad. Let's talk modding. How are the mods for this game? Well, they're really fucking good. I stated earlier that MechWarrior 5 has a good base for gameplay, but the developers don't take advantage of it. In fact, they kind of squander it. But the modders, they've managed to take full advantage of everything the base game has to offer. Which is why I can't play the vanilla game anymore. This game is so much better with mods, like you wouldn't even fucking believe it. The top mods out there are top mods for a reason. That reason being, they actually address some of the shit they left out in the base game. Like if you go to the Nexus page and search for the most popular of all time, the first fucking mod you'll see is yet another mech lab, a genuinely good mod. Why? Because it actually lets you use the mech lab as it should be used. None of that limitation bullshit. You can do whatever you want to your mech with whatever the mod offers you to use. But wait. What's right next to it on the Nexus page? That's right, Coyote's Mission Pack. Another great mod that adds more missions to play with instead of the base 5. And a little over to the side, an AI mod. And I could go on and on and on, but you probably see what I mean. These mods are popular because they actually bring back features that should have been there from the beginning, and they also improve the shit that's already there. That there should tell you the quality control at Piranha. The amount of hard work they put into this game. So much work that they needed modders to finish it for them. Isn't that great? Hey, Piranha, if you love Bethesda's business practices so goddamn much, why don't you fucking marry them? Asshole. Retard. Dipshit. You lazy fuck. But that's enough of them. Let's concentrate on the modders. So, do you have any recommended mods? Well, yeah, I do actually. A handful. As I mentioned earlier, you should try out yet another mech lab. It's a genuinely great mod that improves the experience immensely. And while you're at it, if you're looking for an alternative that concentrates a little bit more on the simulator part of MechWarrior, try out MercTech. It's really fun. It's a bit unpolished, but overall it's not bad. Also pretty damn ambitious. They're trying to add Frankenmechs in the game. Some freaky shit. It's pretty cool. I would also recommend a few HUD mods, because the vanilla mods kind of dog shit. But DLC updates from Piranha pretty much break all the mods. And most HUD mods aren't really updated anymore. It's kind of a tragedy, really. But yeah, that's about it. So in conclusion, what are my final thoughts on MechWarrior 5? Well, here's the deal. MechWarrior 5 had a lot of potential to be something great. An improvement over what came before it, but a combination of Piranha's laziness and overall obvious disinterest in the game franchise just ruined it. And you could tell throughout most of the game that this game was unfinished from the start. It's lacking a lot of features that should be there, and whatever it's not lacking is unpolished or just not really there completely. It's pretty clear there were a lot of ideas that just weren't fully developed or were just simply abandoned, either for one reason or another. And then were later implemented through DLC as a means of siphoning up more cash from their customers. Because really, that's what this game is. It's a cash grab. There is no soap put behind this game. There's clearly no intention to improve the base game beyond whatever they had already released. Which is why you see a lot of missing features being re-released through DLC. That's a tragedy, really. This game could have been a lot more than we got. And the beta trailers and footage and everything that came before the full release just proves this point. So now all we have is the modders picking up the pieces and trying to make this game work as it should have. And although they're doing a really good job at it, it shouldn't be their responsibility to make a fully functioning game that is actually good. And all this just makes me even more worried for the MechWarrior 5 Clans that's coming out this year. And though I admit it's looking pretty good, based on the trailers and teasers Piranha has published, I'm worried they might pull another MechWarrior 5 Mercenaries and just lowball everybody. But at this point, only time will tell. So, should you play this game? Should you invest your time and money into this game? Frankly, not really. The vanilla game is way too bare bones for it to be fun, and you're better off paying for other Battletech games like the real-time strategy that came out in 2018, which is actually pretty good. But if you do insist on playing this one, pirate it and get some mods for it, because frankly, in its current state, without DLC, it's not worth it. Go comment, like, and subscribe. Until next time, Godspeed.